We live in a world that begs us to believe that we are decorations for the world more than anything else, that we need to picture what we look like instead of just living. Just picture it. Let's say you are flipping through a fitness magazine. It will tell you how you can look hotter from behind, or how you can get those flat six-pack abs that everybody else can see. Let's say you are on Instagram. Spend 5 seconds on Instagram. You will see so many selfies from teenage girls and women. You will see fashion bloggers that are just casually giving you a glimpse of their perfectly styled day in every way. Do you find that you survey yourself as you move through your life? That instead of just living and doing and being, you are picturing what you look like doing it? If so, you are not alone. We live in a media world that literally begs us to believe that we're here to be looked at, that we're objects that need to be fixed to decorate the world. And in turn, millions of us self-objectify every day. Now that's a big word, but what self-objectification means, I can put into an example. Let's say that you are sitting in class, and instead of thinking about what the teacher is saying, or that you need to call your mom because you haven't talked to her in a minute, you are thinking, oh my gosh, I look so gross in this seat. My thighs look huge. Should I cross my legs, or should I prop my legs up a little bit better? Because I'm sure the guy sitting next to me thinks my legs look so big. Or, ugh, my shirt is riding up. I need to keep my shirt pulled down and fix my hair because I didn't wash my hair this morning and somebody thinks it's so greasy, I'm sure. You're picturing yourself living instead of just living. And girls and women do this in epidemic rates today. Instead of just being awesome at whatever it is we're supposed to be doing, we also picture ourselves doing it. Can you imagine how this gets in the way of our lives and our health and our progress in every way imaginable? It's crazy.